Volatility creates opportunity. But we don't try and have any view about what the fundamental value of Bitcoin is, and that's a long debate whether it exists at all. But we just trade it based on price performance, and there's opportunity. There's not that much liquidity in it, so it's a tiny position, but it's, you know, we like that anything we can trade, the more different things we can trade, the better it is for us.
Are you using futures? Are you trading Bitcoin itself?
Yeah, no, we're only trading futures. Uh-huh. Basically, the settlement risk you take on the so-called exchanges is really not the sort of thing our clients are looking for us to take.
And is there a rapid institutional adoption? Are people just kind of open-minded about it? How does it sit right now?
I think you would call it a very, very slow adoption. The reality is it's a futures contract. We trade hundreds of futures contracts around the world. You know, people will look at it and try and do things with it, but we don't get asked about it by clients, our institutional clients. I mean, you know, we have pension funds around the world as clients, and honestly, they never ask about Bitcoin.
You're doing it for a reason, though. Is it on the premise that more institutions, I mean, the premise has always been for Bitcoin bulls that institutions will eventually come in, charters for pension funds, et cetera, will be able to then invest in Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies, and there will be a flood of money. Are you a buyer of that premise or no?
No, I mean, we're doing it because it's diversifying. We trade as many different things for as much diversification as we can get. We trade, you know, 10,000 stocks and 600 different markets, and Bitcoin clearly doesn't trade in line with anything else. That makes it diversifying, so it's fun to trade. That's it.
Just given where you said, I wonder if you have a view on a separate area that's gotten so much attention, which is the sort of volatility trading arena. So obviously we had this kind of crescendo of activity, this blow up in the short vol funds. As a strategy, is it alive and well, or is it less active than it had been?
It's definitely less active than it had been. I think the reality is, because of the size of those structured products, the front contract and the second contract on the VIX futures have been basically a false market for a reasonably long time. So we trade.
So those exchange traded notes were kind of wagging the dog.
Yeah, exactly. They were completely wagging the dog. And so we trade the third contract out. And that's been a profitable exercise. It was profitable in February. You know, volatility trading is an interesting opportunity, but you always have to be careful to look at an instrument and make sure it's trading for sensible reasons rather than because one particular thing is driving it.
What's your take on what is behind this volatility? I know that there's so many different answers possibly and a combination of things, but if you really, people will say Syria now and the possibility of a trade war, but really if you take a look at when the volatility started, it happened about 2 months ago when the Fed released its jobs report and there was a hotter than expected wage inflation number. And that was long before the threat of tariffs. That was long before the threat of Syria.
Yeah, exactly. Look, I think there's a lot of noise, but if you look at the stuff that's actually, the reality is last year was a weird market. The idea that we go through with that low volatility in stock markets is not normal. Mid-high teens is normal for stock markets late in cycle, and you can debate how late in the cycle we are, but it's been a long cycle. We're definitely not early in the cycle, right? Late in the cycle, you'd expect volatility to be on average higher. So really what we're seeing now in a sort of, you know, you get 19, 20% equity market vol, that's pretty normal. We just all got used to seeing nothing happening. So, you know, the bits of noise you can look at, the reality is there's enough going on to you know, 1-2% moves every day. It should just be seen as the norm.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.